Hello, welcome back to Mrs. O'Connor's At Home Classroom. So today we are going to begin our analysis of The Alchemist. But first, let's talk about what the word analysis means. What does it mean to analyze something in literature? Well, a literary analysis is a careful evaluation and examination of textual details. And we do this to more deeply interpret an author's meaning, to more deeply interpret the messages made clear and available to us by way of the text. And literary analysis can be fun and exciting, like detective work. So we are going to analyze The Alchemist in three different ways, specifically this week. And next week, you'll get to pick one of these analysis elements to focus on a deeper level. All right, so our first analysis of The Alchemist is going to compare the process of uncovering one's personal legend and the process of alchemy. So Paulo Coelho goes into detail on both these pursuits throughout the novel. So on one hand, we have our personal legend, right? Putting in the blood, sweat, and tears, whatever it takes to make it big, achieve your dream, do what you've always wanted to do in the bottom of your heart, or alchemy, taking a piece of common metal and turning it into gold. How did I do that? I've had two spoons this whole time. I didn't really. I can't do alchemy. Let's dig deeper here with these two questions. The first question, what is the value in each process? What is the value of achieving your personal legend? And what is the value of understanding alchemy? The second dig deeper question here would be, what would these understandings bring to a reader? So what would the understanding of uncovering a personal legend bring to the reader versus what would understanding the process of alchemy bring to the reader? Okay, so the next element of The Alchemist that we are going to analyze this week is going to be the idea of achieving a dream or having a dream. So let's go take a poll. I really only have access to the people in this house because of this quarantine, whether or not it's better to have a dream or achieve a dream. Hey Tessa, what's better, having a dream or achieving a dream?
Achieving a dream.
Achieving a dream? All right. Hey Bear, what's better, having a dream or achieving a dream?
He said, achieving a dream.
What did he say?
Achieving a dream.
Achieving a dream? Having a dream or achieving a dream?
Achieving a dream.
So it's unanimous. We all kind of want to achieve our dreams. But I think this is a very surface level analysis of this phenomenon. Think about a dream vacation. Let's say you've always wanted to go to Greece, and you've planned and you've read history books. You've made reservations. It's been years. You've saved the money for the plane ticket and you finally go. And maybe it's not what you've always imagined it would be. So this idea is discussed in The Alchemist through Santiago, our go-getter, our dream chaser, and our dream achiever, versus the crystal merchant, who doesn't want to achieve his dream of going to Mecca because he's worried that he'll lose that as the bright spot to look forward to at the end of the tunnel. He doesn't want to just persist in a dark tunnel for the rest of his life. He wants to have something to look forward to. And if he does it, and if he goes and achieves it, then it's gone. So digging deeper here would almost look like playing devil's advocate. It seems clear to us that achieving a dream would be better because it's what we have been told. It's the way every hero's journey concludes. But there is truth to what the Crystal Merchant is saying. The idea of losing something to look forward to. In achieving a dream, you also lose a dream because it becomes reality. And that reality may not be as golden and beautiful as you have imagined it for your entire life. And then you also have the result of the novel itself to analyze here. So you have both characters to look at the end of this book. You have Santiago, who now is wealthy and is off to get the love of his life and has many doors of possibilities opened to him because he did, in fact, achieve his dream. And then you have our crystal merchant, who is still where we found him when we encountered him initially in the novel. And this brings us to our final venue of analysis for The Alchemist. We are going to evaluate whether or not the message of this novel was effective for you. So after reading this book, did you feel like chasing a personal legend, trying to figure out what your personal legend may even be? Did this novel inspire you in the way it has for so many others? We talked about how Will Smith, Pharrell, Madonna, Oprah, so many celebrities have been driven towards, you know, their success with stories like this to stand on, right? With inspiration from texts like this that show you the value of laying it all on the line for what you've always wanted to be and what you've always wanted to do.